बापू, स्वातंत्र्याचा लढा मांडला नव्हती हाती शस्त्रे, सत्याग्रह अन उपोषणे ही दिव्यचं होती अश्रे, परभूमीतील अपमानांची ठिणगी मशाल झाली, स्वातंत्र्याची विचारक्षितिजे अजूनच विशाल झाली, सत्य अहिंसा शक्ती होती जगा अनोखी भेट, विश्वशांतीची शिकवण आमच्या हृदयी रुजली थेट, मीठमुठवर उचलून केली परसत्ता बेजार, उपोषणाचा मार्ग अनोखा ठरला अपरंपार, परसत्तेच्या निष्ठुर काठ्या पढल्या माथ्यावरती, देशप्रेम या दिव्य विचारास सांगा कसली भीती, मैत्रभाव अन सहजगण्याची जगास कळली महती, जगभर साऱ्या देशा उमगे शांतीमधूनच प्रगती, सत्य अहिंसा उपोषणांनी जेरीस आली सत्ता, परसत्ता ती लौपुण झाली स्वतंत्र भारत माता।
गांधी आज असते तर मला काय म्हणाले असते? कौतुक केलं असतं माझं की जरा रागवले असते? हिशेब विचारला असता का स्वातंत्र्यानंतरचा की रस्ता दाखवला असता त्यांनी जंतर मंतरचा? चळवळ एखादी उभी करू असे बोलले असते का? कार्यकर्ते जमवण्यासाठी पैसे दिले असते का? ड्राय डेबद्दल एकदा स्पष्ट बोलून घेतलं असतं, नाईलाज म्हणून बंद ठेवतो सरळ सांगून दिलं असतं, रागवलेच असते जास्त तर एक आश्वासन देऊन देव चार पुतळ्यांचा पुन्हा नवीन भूमिपूजन करून घेऊ। आज अहिंसेचा रस्ता बापू हिंसेतून जात आहे, म्हणून बापू सारा देश तुमची वाट पाहत आहे, म्हणून बापू सारा देश तुमची वाट पाहत आहे।
The Revolutionary Treaty. The year was 1913. There was constant unrest among the people, but it was now finally going to be over. After the arrest of India's greatest leader Mahatma Gandhi during the Dandi March, people started the rebelling against the British East India Company by starting the civil disobedience movement. By the end of year 1930, thousands and hundreds of patriotic Indians were imprisoned, but that did not discourage the young leaders who were aspiring of seeing the dawn of an independent India. Lord Irwin, the then Viceroy of India, was fed up of the constant rebellions, and thus he at last decided to set free Mahatma Gandhi. Celebrations began in the whole country. Everyone was eager that now their beloved Bapu was going to be free. But when Lord Irwin went to free Mahatma Gandhi, he asked for a treaty to be made. Gandhiji asked for a pact to be made with Lord Irwin, which would not only mark the end of the civil disobedience movement, but will also result in the discontinuation of the salt satyagraha. But in return, Mahatma Gandhi asked for 7 demands from the British government. Lord Irwin agreed, and thus a date was fixed. On the 5th of March 1931, the famous Gandhi-Irwin Pact was signed. The pact stated that the British government would release all the prisoners who participated in the Salt March and the civil disobedience movement, as well as the political prisoners. It also demanded the removal of ban on Congress. This was indeed a big step taken by Mahatma Gandhi, which made revolutionary changes in India, later leading to independence.